close, and you still had a real shot there for a long time.
I like the pairings. I like the matchup. I thought it was good for us. And you know, Thomas Dietrich has gotten off such a good start all week. But you know, he's a young kid. He's a freshman. He's very talented. You know, our ranking, our individual rankings, people talk all week about. Don't want to do our guys justice. We don't play the same type of schedule that these Southern schools play. We have to be a little more picky and a little more smart with our schedule sometimes. So our players are better than the rankings, and I think they showed that. And Thomas to go out well would have been good today. But you know, Bobby Wyatt's a great player, and you know, you can tell Alabama had an edge to them today that they've been through this last year. Mm-hmm. Going through it once and not winning is a powerful feeling when you group that together and you come back this year, and you can tell they had their mind made up, they was going to get done. And we're up against the buzzsaw today. Jay does a great job. I have so much respect for him, and I knew it was going to be tough. I knew, especially after yesterday, after the high yesterday. You know, you talk about sports, you beat somebody, and then all of a sudden, it's tough to keep doing it again and again when you have, especially freshmen and sophomores. So, but you know, Thomas got off the slow start. That was fine. It's okay. Three other guys battled hard, all fought in there, but we didn't play as well as we have played. And you need to play that well against Alabama to beat them. And we didn't play as well. We didn't drive it as well, and we didn't putt it as well. Two things you need. Because they're good. And when you're not sharp, they're going to trounce on you and just make you pay.
Coach, how difficult is it after coming off an emotional win like you had yesterday? What do you say to them last night to make sure that they know the job isn't done yet?
You know, in our program, we always talk about that, not a lot, because we say talk is cheap.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean? And so we didn't talk a lot. We just there's a vibe we wanted to have that we'd gotten yesterday, and just keep it going. But to dig deep in the well, I mean, we came in here, you know, trying to make match play, and like everybody else was, that's what you have to do, and then it wears you out. And then you go to the first match, and that wears you out. When you beat Texas, and then you beat Cal, and then you go against Alabama, that's three of the best. I think that's the Big 12, the Pac-12, and the SEC champions, isn't it?
Yep.
And we're Big 10 champions, so we fit. But it's still a mindset you have to bring every day, and there's no room for error against any of those teams.
Mm-hmm.
So we really had to play 3 days with no error, and we did for the most part. We were in it. I mean, it could have gone either way after about 12 or 13 today still, and then they just put the hammer down the last three or four holes, which is what it is. But it was a chance, and this was not a pipe dream at all. I think we proved it.
You impressed with the way your young guys responded this week? Not a lot of, you know, national experience.
You know, I was impressed by the way they responded to the Big Ten Championship when we went in there as the favorite, going for five in a row with that pressure. I was happy with going to regionals when that's the most nerve-wracking part of the whole year. Go to regionals because you don't make it there, then the season's done. And then we go win that thing against some top 10 teams and come here. It's just been piling on. These kids have really answered the bell, and they have not played from fear at all. And I don't think today there was any fear. I think today there was maybe a little bit of you know, nervousness that we couldn't get a hold of, and anxiousness maybe. But like I said, Alabama's good. So, I mean, they beat us, and we couldn't make any mistakes against them today, and we did.